Earth 200 million years ago was a very different place from now. For starters, Earth only had one continent, Pangaea, which later, with tectonic plates moving, split into many more continents that we have today. So all of today's continents can fit inside Pangaea, almost perfectly. Pangaea was surrounded by a gigantic ocean, Pantalassa, or Old Pacific, which covered 70% of the whole surface. So then, what would going back in time and spending a day on Earth 200 million years ago be like? It should be noted that a day on Earth 200 million years ago was around 23 hours, not 24 hours. So let's put you in North American part of Pangaea, which was ruled by dinosaurs, as well as the whole surface. And generally, reptiles and cold-blooded creatures were all over Pangaea. So let's say you were roaming around in one of the forests there. It would be quite an experience. You would see many alien-like species, or at least many different species, that didn't survive or adapt and are not present in today's world. I mean, just to think about it, it is estimated that 99% of all species that ever existed went extinct. And 20 million years ago, many more mass extinction events were to come. So just in the forest, you would see many species of fascinating trees, insects and reptiles that didn't get to survive. You would see how they move, eat, act and look. It would be the greatest throwback in time. But there would be no flowers, bees, ants, snakes and any mammals and tons upon tons of species on Earth that are present today. The whole surface would look somewhat different. Many mountains have been formed that are not here today, as well as many ancient deserts. Interestingly, part of Antarctica was not covered in snow. There were no snowy wastelands, and since Antarctica was a bit closer to the equator, meaning there maybe was a huge chunk of desert, but as well parts that were covered with vegetation. So today's Antarctica is nothing alike old Antarctica, which possibly had forests with many organisms living in it. The climate of the whole planet was as well very different. Distribution of cold and warm temperature was very different because of continents, which changed wind paths. Occasionally, while roaming around Asian forests, a group of flying reptiles, petrosaurs, with their 10-meter wingspan would fly over. Finding dinosaurs on Pangaea as well wouldn't be very hard, since they are the top predators before mammals. From finding aeroraptors, which are actually just 1 meter in length, not that big, to finding the biggest dinosaurs and biggest organisms to have ever walked the surface of Earth, Turiosaurus, Supersaurus, and many other gigantic dinosaurs. They were 39 meters in length, which is comparable to the height of a 10-story building. Still, you should keep a distance from these giants. But if they spot you, they likely wouldn't try to eat you, since they likely only ate vegetation. Who knows what would go through their brains while seeing a creature from future. But there were predatory dinosaurs, so keeping a distance is good. So then, let's travel to see Pantalassa, the big ocean. The water seems inviting as always, but this time, it has more sharks and other species that are predators. Just 100 meters off the coast, the danger will rise drastically. Taking a deep dive again, same as on the surface, there would be unrecognizable species living in the ocean. From large sharks to reptile-like fish to other unknown species. So this would be all great, but the big problem is that just a single human could contaminate the whole world with its viruses from the future, which we are immune to. But at this time, there was the earliest evidence of virus presence through cells being infected. So you might pick up some type of virus that is deadly to today's humans. Still, there might have been even earlier viruses. Viruses are poorly understood and we can't even decide whether or not they are alive. So then we can see that if we had a time machine, it would be worth it to go back in time 200 million years ago to see what was before the existence of whole humanity, which arised very early compared to organisms that were here before us. it would be one of the best throwbacks we never got to experience.